Welcome back to the Unwritten Hour YouTube channel, the home of album reviews, discography guides and think pieces. Now today's review is a review of the brand new EP from Kae Tempest called Nice Idea. Now Kae Tempest, I think, is definitely one of the more fresher names in music at the moment. I first discovered their stuff, I think, in lockdown, if I remember correctly. And I was just, to put it one way, I was completely blown away with the mix of, like, really dark, gritty, cinematic hip-hop production, slightly esoteric as well, mixed with Kae's, like, really authoritative, but also, at times, emotional and very narrative-centric slam poetry that went throughout their albums. I thought it was incredibly captivating, the way that they managed to weave narratives throughout albums and create a whole story told with a really gritty, nice hip-hop backdrop with, like, really convincing lyrics, vitriolic delivery. It was amazing. I loved it. Particularly their album Let Them Eat Chaos, I think, is my personal favourite. But also an album like The Books of Traps and Lessons were certainly brilliant as well. But for me, their last album, The Line Is a Curve, was a bit of a dip in my kind of appreciation for their stuff. Mainly because, as I say, their previous stuff had relied on not only a very dark, grimy, gritty sound palette, slightly otherworldly as well, but also, as I say, the narratives that they weave throughout their albums, creating stories, whereas this last album seemed the most like a collection of songs, just like a random collection of songs, than any of their albums before it, and so didn't quite have that narrative cohesion going for it. But also, the instrumental choices, as much as I did like some of the tracks off the album, because I feel like whatever context they're put in, Kae's vocal delivery will always shine through, and Dan Carey's production will, for most of the time, be pretty good. But I felt like a lot of the instrumental choices felt a lot less, like, unique to them, and just more, felt a bit drier, a bit blander, and so, in all honesty, probably ended up being my least favourite project that they've put out thus far. But we did get news of a brand new release for Record Store Day, an exclusive EP, which is now out on streaming, called Nice Idea, which apparently was recorded in a quick break from touring, like a couple week break, and they just kind of, you know, went in the studio, banged these tracks out, and here they are, bam, you know, that kind of thing. And to be fair, that can be brilliant. Like, I know there are plenty of examples of bands who, like, without the pressure of an album on them, without the pressure of having to write and release a project on them, they can come out with great stuff. But again, it links back to my problem with the previous album, where, like, you know, not having that same sense of focus and cohesion and kind of, you know, uniqueness to the project and just banging out four songs. I didn't know what I was going to really make of this. Was it going to be four tracks that were just great and brilliant and, you know, and they just banged them out and it was amazing? Or would it be a case of, like, oh, you know, they wrote four tracks, but then without the weight of, like, a narrative or a concept or, like, a musical cohesion behind it, that, you know, they would just kind of fall flat? And I wasn't really sure. But after a good few listens, here's what I thought of the new Kae Tempest EP, Nice Idea. The opener is the track Love Harder, which, to be honest, I feel kind of mixed on, because instrumentally, I actually thought this was quite strong. Like, it's fairly brief, sure, but I think it has some very good ideas behind it. For instance, I feel like the way the really nice plucky synths and the deep bass go together in the instrumental is a very nice pairing. And as much as I do like the acoustic kind of ride cymbal groove in the intro, the way they quickly transition into a kind of more electronic thumping beat with some extra additional psychedelic electronics is also a very cool sound and gives it a generally more hazy atmosphere that I actually think works well with the plucks and the bass and what have you to create a very nice enveloping feel to the whole song. And to be fair, there isn't a lot of, like, musical development, but what they have here is very warm, very colourful, very enveloping. And, you know, I think even if they did go with the ride cymbal groove throughout the whole track, maybe it would have been a bit static after a while, but I think it's still, you know, a decent touch to the track. So instrumentally, you know, it might be pretty basic, but it's still decent, I think, by all means. And I also think that Kae's delivery isn't too bad either. Like, they kind of go for a more laid-back, reserved delivery, but also that has a kind of commandingness to it and a kind of authority to it, which is quite nice, like a confidence, rather, is what I would say. So it manages to be more reserved, not be as, like, in your face, while still kind of carrying a gravitas to it, which is quite nice. And I also think that the very heavily accented chorus is actually quite a cool moment. The way that they managed to really bend the syllables to create that chorus, I actually think is a fairly decent effect. Like, it might not be for everybody, but for me, I think it works for what the track is going for. But lyrically, I'm not really sure about this one, because, like, I understand where the track is coming from, and I do, like, sympathise or empathise, whichever one it is, but I, you know, because I imagine that with Kae being a non-binary person, having people that are maybe more traditional or what have you in their values, and, like, you know, whenever Kae might come up to them or see them or whatever, they sort of, you know, get a bit standoffish and a bit ignorant and kind of what have you. I understand the frustrations that can probably come with that, but the way that it's phrased in this song seems less like angry in a passionate way and more just kind of like annoyed and sarcastic and stuff like that, which again, I can understand because I'm sure the frustration's real and I get it, but it just translates a little bit weird. Like, lyrics like, oh, your family values melt under the heat of my presence, and like calling people salty and stuff like that. Like, it feels like if they were gonna have a stab at this topic, they could have done it in a bit more of a kind of, I don't want to say tactful way, because that's, it's not like it's completely tactless, more of an understanding way maybe, or like trying to get to the bottom of an issue rather than just being like, oh, you know, I threaten your values, you're salty, because it just kind of comes across a bit weird. So while it's brief, I did quite enjoy the very psychedelic electronic instrumental, and the vocal performance was solid, but the lyrics kind of, like, as much as I understand the sentiment behind them, kind of leave a bit of a weird taste in my mouth for whatever reason. A lover like me learns to be a fighter when it gets darker. Track number two is called Thinking Clearly, and for me, while there are a couple of good ideas here or there, for the most part for me this track is just a bit of a miss, because instrumentally I wasn't really a big fan of what it was trying to do here. Like, the big kind of blocky bass sound wasn't my favourite, and the drums on here sound kind of like skittery and offbeat and kind of weird. Like, they don't have, like, I get trying to go for like a bit more of an offbeat drum groove kind of thing, because sometimes that can work, but it doesn't like have a heft or even like much of a groove to it. Like, there's offbeat drum beats where, you know, that can kind of work, you know, that kind of to and froing thing, but it just doesn't like carry that groove that you want. If you're gonna do an offbeat thing, you really want it to have some kind of, you know, thing that you can like bop along to, or, you know, you can kind of get into the rhythm of, whereas this one just kind of feels a bit all over the place and a bit odd. And even some of the synth layers, while I do like some of them because they are quite, you know, warm and psychedelic sounding, a couple of them granted, but a lot of them just kind of seem very generic and just kind of a bit meh. Like, you know, the synths aren't bad. I'd say the synths are probably one of the more tolerable elements of the instrumental, precisely because some of them are a bit more psychedelic, a bit more enveloping and what have you, but a lot of them are just kind of very nondescript as far as synthesizer sounds go, so it's a bit of a disappointment on the instrumental front. Vocally, it's all right. I think Kae does a decent job, because they go for like a more like a projected out there kind of angry passionate delivery. Well, not quite angry, but definitely passionate. You know, the lines are really delivered with force and conviction, which is very nice. And there's also some very cool flows throughout the track. Like, their flow is like consistently relentless throughout this track, particularly on the back end where like the fast, I believe they're triplets, they just go and go and go and go, and it has a really cool effect to it. So delivery wise this track is actually decent, but lyrically it seems to be kind of focusing on what I perceive to be quite an overdone and if anything quite cringy topic about like, oh, you know, because of like wanting to get like approval from people and what have you, we let social media and the internet kind of dictate our thoughts and our feelings on things, and, you know, social media controls your brains and makes you think and feel a certain way and blah blah blah, and that whole kind of like Orwellian angle to social media. It was done on the latest Enter Shikari album as well, on tracks like Bloodshot, and I wasn't a fan of those either, so it would make sense that I'm not really a huge fan of this. So in a lot of ways this track was pretty much a miss. Like, the really slow, lethargic, weird, offbeat instrumental didn't really do much for me. And I completely forgot to mention, the vocoders on this song do not sound good at all, because the chorus, I think, was trying to go for a kind of sci-fi thing, maybe, with the way the vocoder effects are applied. But it just feels like a really weird, either it's a really weird melody that they're singing, or just the vocoder effects sound really cheap, but it doesn't sound good by any means. So yeah, aesthetically, this track didn't really do much for me sonically. Kae's performance was decent though, but that's about the only decent real thing that I can give this song, because not only did I not like the instrumental very much, or a lot of the aesthetic choices, a lot of the vocoders, but also the lyrics just seemed like a bit Orwellian and a bit overdone and a bit cringy, which, you know, you wouldn't normally expect from Kae, because they normally attack subjects from quite an interesting angle, but on this one it feels like they just didn't bother.
Thinking clearly, staying focused, taking care, thinking clearly, staying focused, paying attention, thinking clearly.
The third track is the lead single, Nice Idea, and this one I think is actually probably the EP's main highlight for me, because it does a lot of things very, very well. To start with the instrumental, I feel like the very stately pianos that go throughout the beat here are very well done, very nice sounding, and I feel like they work very well with the more kind of subtle trap style beat that goes in the intro. But then when the breakbeats are introduced, they might be really like snappy and metallic and bombastic and really fast paced, but they still don't take away from the melody that's underneath them. Like, you can still hear the pianos quite clearly and they work quite well, and though, you know, I do quite like the more jazzy breakbeat style stuff. I mean, granted, they probably wouldn't go for a breakbeat that's this bombastic, but even so, I think it works here. And not only that, but I also think that the layers of synths that go throughout the chorus section on top of the pianos sound incredible, really warm and psychedelic and colourful and brilliant. They sound amazing. And then when on the, I believe it's the second chorus, they kind of leave out the synth layers but have the piano playing a kind of different melody over the top of the chorus, that's also quite nice. So instrumentally, it is fairly simplistic, but the stuff that it does with this very simplistic instrumental, I think works very, very well. Like a nice beat, some decent piano layers, some great synth sounds, it works very well. I've got no complaints. And I think this track is, if anything, summed up by like simplicity works. And I feel like that's the same with Kae's vocal delivery, because they seem to, again, have that kind of commanding delivery, that more authoritative or confident delivery, but more reserved this time around. And I don't think the confidence is really to do with, you know, the delivery of a really urgent point or anything like that, but it, you know, it's more of a kind of, it feels more self-assured than confident is what I would say, because these lyrics are actually quite endearing, about kind of seeking refuge from a turbulent world by just like spending all day in bed with your loved one and having a good time, smoking, what, doing whatever. And that's, you know, that's cool, that's quite endearing, and I quite like it. And I think the way that it's like, you know, they have the more stern delivery in the verses, kind of talking about, oh, you know, life can be shit sometimes, but then in the chorus the delivery seems to be more kind of, you know, a bit softer maybe, just kind of, you know, and you can sort of feel the emotion coming through a little bit, although it is maybe more deadpan than emotional, you can still feel that kind of yearning just for like a bit of, you know, life, like enjoying the simpler things, you know. And I think that sentiment comes across quite well in the vocal performance, as well as the way that it's put forward in the lyrics, I think is also quite good. So yeah, this track is very simplistic, but I enjoyed it, you know. A nice, lively, but also jazzy and soulful beat, some endearing lyrics, a decent vocal performance. It was good.
I wanna stay in bed with you all day. I wanna stay in bed with you all day. I wanna stay in bed with you all day. I wanna.
And the fourth and final track is called Split the Atom. And this one, instrumentally, I would say is a win all around, because it goes for a more kind of classic jazz rap style of instrumental on this one, kind of like the jazz breakbeat of the last track, but a bit more kind of classic. There's a real Tribe Called Quest vibe sort of coming through here, which is nice, you know, some really cool sounding guitars, clean guitars, and these really nice acrobatic bendy double bass lines that go underneath the track are also very nice. And it's complemented by a drum beat that is very metallic, and so I suppose on paper could sound a little out of place, but it has a decent thump to it and a nice groove to it, and I think works well with the bass line and the guitars, and also as a kind of textural element of interest or a bit of difference, it works quite nicely. Granted, there's not a lot of variation throughout the instrumental, and I wish there kind of was maybe like a switch or two going into the chorus, because like it literally does kind of subsist off the same 15 second loop for its entire runtime. That is, aside from the switch in the last 20 seconds or so, where they kind of switch up the sample a little bit and do some odd splicing with it, which, like, I suppose it would have been fine if they used this, like, sample source throughout the whole of the song, or at least, like, as a switch in the chorus, maybe. But the way they actually splice the sample and the way they introduce it into the song feels very odd, because the main sample that they use, while it is repetitive, it is kind of sampled and spliced in quite a nice sounding way, whereas a lot of the splices on the beat switch part just sound quite jarring and weird, and a lot of the drum tom samples feel very out of place as well. So it's a weird switch, and one that, if it was maybe utilized better as a sample source, could have been something quite interesting, but just feels a bit odd really, for all intents and purposes. But vocally, I think Kae is back to basically doing what they do best, you know, that kind of commanding, authoritative delivery, but with slightly more urgency to it this time around, I would say. You know, they have that real delivery of like a real narrator kind of explaining the woes and the turbulence and the kind of shitty monotony of life, which I think is put across really well in the song, because the song is another one, kind of like the last track, where it's about, you know, desperately seeking from like a refuge from the constant monotony of life, like, you know, take the dog out for a walk, it's raining, go out, do this thing, do that thing, over and over and over again, and just kind of, you know, desperately wanting a release, wanting something different, wanting something new, and it's put across quite well. The one thing I would say, though, is as much as I do like Kae's vocal delivery, they've basically used the same vocal delivery for like 3 out of the 4 tracks, like that very reserved but also commanding and authoritative and confident delivery. Like Love Harder, Nice Idea, and this track have all basically used that exact same delivery, and so I wish, kind of like the beat, that they would have varied it up a bit more. But the performance is decent and the lyrics are quite good as well. And to be fair, as much as the switch in the last 20 seconds might be a bit weird, I think the beat works fairly well too. So I'd take this one as a win. Wake up, split the atom, take her to the train, walk the dog in the pounding rain, looking for a way out of my brain, trapped in it. So, what did I think of Kae Tempest's brand new EP, Nice Idea? Well, I'm kind of sad to report that my skepticisms about this album, or this EP rather, broadly, were kind of true. Because, yes, there are a couple good tracks here, particularly on the B-side, but, like, because of how, like, you know, not narratively connective it is, and because of how quickly it came together, and because of how brief the project is, it just kind of feels very low impact. Like, I suppose in a way it suffers from the same problem as the mainline album, The Line Is a Curve, but just to a lesser extent because it's shorter, really. Like, there's some good ideas here, some ideas that aren't executed so well, none of which have very much cohesion between them at all, and I wish that maybe Kae would have, because the EP is so short, I wish they would have maybe varied up their vocals a little bit more just to keep things interesting. And that's the thing, this EP isn't even 12 minutes long, but it recycles a lot of the same ideas, at least on a vocal performance front. And, like, you know, some of the things it's going for don't really work. So, you know, you really need to keep that interest, even for such a short runtime. And do I think this EP does that? Not really. Like, again, it's got some good ideas on the back end, but just because it's so brief and because it's kind of doing vaguely, it's not really going too far out of Kae's or Dan's comfort zone, and it hasn't got that structural or musical cohesion to it, that it just feels very inconsequential and just very, it just feels like a bit of a pointless release, which I get for like Record Store Day, that might kind of tend to be the case. But you'd think, like, you know, I always thought that there could have been the chance that, you know, just in like a really short space of time, produce 4 great tracks, even if they don't have that much cohesion behind them, whatever, they're still great, bang. But I think what happens is probably what's more likely to happen in that kind of scenario is that, you know, you go into the studio for a little bit, bang out some tracks, some of them are good, some of them aren't very good, and then when you put them together, it just kind of feels a bit broadly meh. So if I had to give a score to this EP, it'd be like a light 6 probably. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please do consider liking and subscribing. It would really mean a lot to me. I know, because I'm filming all these videos in quite quick succession, it's getting difficult to find stuff to talk about in these little end cards, and I am aware that they can probably get a bit tedious for repeat viewers. But, you know, I think it's good to have these bit at the end where I can just, like, brain fart some ideas out. Speaking of, I actually thought that because, you know, I'm not the best at coming up with ideas sometimes, like, I'm not an endless well of, like, creativity and ideas, if that's, you know, if that's too difficult to believe. But I would be interested in what you would want to see from me in the future, like not necessarily just with like album reviews, like can you cover this album or that album or whatever, but like whether there are any topics that you would like me to cover in the future, or whether there are any kind of formats that you think I should give a go, or like cover anything particularly, or just like anything that interests you that you would like me to maybe take a dive into. I'll have a look, and you know, if I think it might make a cool video, who knows, I might go for it. So if you've got any ideas for content that I could do, let me know in the comments, and I'll, you know, if it's good enough, I might make a video on it. I mean, that sounds a bit kind of like I want your ideas, but not if they're shit. But like, you know, I'm sure a lot of you do have quite a few decent ideas, so you know, if I see one that catches my eye, you might see it in your sub box at some point later on this year. But you know, you never know, do you? So until next time, I'll see you all later.